Unacademy. Let's crack it.
Hi, I'm Shailja Beria, currently studying at NUJS Kolkata. I was CLAT rank 6 and I'm coming live on Thursday, 8th of July with Unacademy CLAT's top educator, Kushal Singh. For those of you giving CLAT 2021, I would like to wish you all the best. Remember, this is the last part of your journey before you start law school. So make the most of it, give your best, and get to the college that you want. In the last leg of preparation, I would like to give you some tips. I hope that this is helpful. So make sure to analyze your past mocks and work on your weaknesses. For GK, you could make a list of the topics which you feel are most important in recent current affairs. So once you have that list, try to focus on. So for me, I picked around 20 topics and I tried my best to cover everything about those topics. Remember that the CLAT paper, based on the pattern, you could at most have 14 to 16 topics, including GK and legal reasoning. So you have to make sure that you pick the most appropriate topics. They tend to focus on topics which are important. So if you are able to find those 20 topics and you are able to prepare them most as thoroughly as you can, then it will be a lot more helpful than making an extensive list and just covering it on the surface. So this is something that is really helpful for GK. Make sure that you are very confident about the topics that you feel are important. Okay, so after that, for English, legal reasoning and logical reasoning, the most important part is speed with accuracy. So I'm sure y'all have done a lot of reading and practice by this point. So try to fill the gaps that you have already identified. Try to focus on those areas that you are unsure of. Make sure that when you analyze mocks, not only do you check up the correct answers, but you also convince yourselves of the reasoning in those answers. Okay, so for all these topics, that is for English, legal reasoning and logical reasoning, it is very important to know what is the logic you are applying to each of the questions. Also, make sure that you pace yourself well. It never helps to sacrifice accuracy for better speed. Okay, so there's that. Then for quantitative aptitude, revise each of the concepts and once again work on those topics where you feel that you lack confidence. So it often happens that while preparing the topics that we are weakest in, we sort of leave them for the end. Now remember that this is the end and this is when you brush up on all those topics that you were unsure of and make sure you clear all your doubts and also make sure that you have a good speed while doing all this. Also remember that this is the last leg of your preparation. You have been preparing for the past 6 months or 1 year or 2 years and nobody knows better than you what you need at this point. So this is not the time to focus on your percentile or your ranks or on comparing with someone else on how they are doing in particular sections. This is the time to focus only on doing your best. So make sure that you look at your own strengths and weaknesses and you make sure that you attempt your paper accordingly. Okay, so while attempting the paper, try to attempt it as if it is just another mock that you are giving. But if that's not possible, then try to just at least keep your stress at a minimum. It's best to try to look at the paper as if it's another mock that you are attempting. And if the paper feels difficult, don't panic. It'll be difficult for everyone. And as long as you are well prepared, you will still get a good rank and percentile. So make sure that you focus on your own attempt and give your best attempt with good accuracy. Try to finish as many questions as you can. And if the paper feels lengthy, then make sure to attempt those sections and those questions that you are most confident on. This is very important because if the paper is relatively easy but still lengthy, then your attempt, the questions that you attempt will matter the most. Because if you are able to attempt the easier questions, then that will give you a huge advantage. Okay, so there's that. And make sure that you give your best attempt. and your preparation is sure to pay off. So once you've given the examination, you will be faced with filling forms and choosing which college you want to go to. Each of you will have your own considerations, so do not decide based on what is expected of you or what each college ranks. Remember, the rank of the college is only one of the factors in influencing your decision. Look at your own interests, look at the opportunities that each college offers. Also look at the location of the college, the kind of experiences you are looking forward to in college and whether that particular college is conducive to that, and then decide. Okay? So right now CLAT will be your focus, but make sure to talk to students from different colleges and do sufficient research of your own so that you can decide based on your preference. Okay? So for example, I chose NUJS as it is in my hometown. At the same time, the focus on co-curriculars and the moving culture has been a huge bonus. In the past 1 year at NUJS, all my batchmates got an opportunity to explore different interests, very varied interests. I myself got to participate in an international moot court competition, and we even came runners up in that one. So we could participate in moots, we had ADR competitions, we had debates, and we could be part of different societies, we could write and publish articles, take up editing positions in different journals, and so on. So overall, the experience has been very enriching, and each of the different law schools give you enough opportunities to discover your own interests and to hone your skills. There is also a very vast support system of seniors and professors who are always willing to help you find your way, even being always available online. So at the end of the day, you have to make the best use of your time at whichever college you go to. You will have ample opportunities irrespective of where you are, and it is upon you to prove yourself. Also, I really hope that your batch will be luckier and will be able to start their law school experience offline. So for now, just focus on CLAT, make sure you give your best, and once again, all the best. For those attempting CLAT 2022 and 2023, I will be coming live on 8 July, 5 p.m. with Unacademy. In this session, we will discuss about preparing for CLAT in the 11th and 12th standard and on how to balance it with the pressure of school and boards. So I will answer all your questions based on my own experience, considering that I gave CLAT in after giving my board exams. And so I constantly felt that pressure that you must be feeling at this point. And I hope that it will be an informative and helpful session. So thank you and all the best. Look forward to seeing you on Thursday. Thank you.